And why aren't you in bed tonight, Dragon?
Oh, Aunt Barber, I broke a mirror. It's 5 years bad luck if you break a mirror. I'm trying to fix it.
What rubbish? Who told you that?
Everyone knows that.
Well, you shouldn't believe everything everyone tells you. And it's 7 years, anyway.
7 years? No, I'll be 9 then.
Try 10.
10? No.
But little dragon, a broken mirror is nothing. It's just a piece of glass. Breaking a mirror is nothing to worry about. Believe me, there is worse.
Is there?
Yes, there is. It's called a curse. And it's so bad and so terrible that even I tremble like a twig in a hurricane at the thought of it.
No, even you aren't, Babar.
Yes, even me. Would you like to hear a story about the time a terrible curse came to Dragon Valley?
Oh, yes, please.
Well, okay then, little dragon. Are you sitting comfortably? It all started one lovely summer morning in the gardens of Castle Milly.
Okay now, poor. Give Smokey a paw. No, paw. Paw. Come on. Give Smokey your paw, and Smokey will give you a lovely fresh carrot. Hi, Smokey. What are you doing? Are you making breakfast? Oh, no. No, Milly. So what are you doing with that chicken? I'm trying to teach it a trick. A trick? Yes, I'm trying to teach this chicken to give me its paw before she can have a carrot. But, Smokey, chickens don't have paws. No. No. And I don't think they eat carrots either. No. And I don't think they can even do tricks. No. I don't think so. I've never seen one at the circus. But, Milly, this isn't an ordinary chicken. No. No, it's a golden chicken. A golden chicken? Yeah. Wow. It doesn't look very golden. No, Milly, it's not called a golden chicken because it's golden. No. No, it's because it lays golden eggs. Wow. How many golden eggs has she laid? Let me see. 1, 3, 6, 40. Well, nothing yet, but she will soon. You'll see. Yes. Smokey, this is my new friend, Amelia. Hello, Amelia. Nice to meet you.
Hello. Nice to meet you, too. I really like your chicken. Does she have a name?
Yes, Amelia. She's called Caesar.
Chicken Caesar? Are you sure that's a good name for her?
Yes, why?
Well, it's a boy's name.
Oh.
Oh, look, Milly, it's that dog, Wolfie, from number 7. He's coming this way. Quick, Smokey, hide your chicken.
But why? He's okay.
I'm not sure. I like him.
Me neither. He's weird.
No, he's a good doggy, really.
Well, he'll probably want to eat your chicken. He's not from Dragon Valley, you know. And he looks funny, and smells funny, and speaks funny. And he spits. I don't trust him.
Oh, me neither. All that sniffing and scratching. And what he does behind the trees.
Oh, yuck!
Here he comes.
Hello, everyone. And what are you doing with that chicken? Is it lunchtime?
Oh, no, Wolfie. I'm teaching it a trick. Well, I was, but Milly says chickens don't do tricks.
Oh, that's a real shame. Well, shall we just eat her, then? I'll get the ketchup.
No, Wolfie. No, she's not for eating.
No?
No.
No?
No. No.
Just a little wing?
No.
No.
Okay. Excuse me, I just got to visit the tree. Oh, tree, tree.
That wolfie, I do not like him.
Yes, let's go before he comes back. Smokey, we must be going. See you later.
Yeah, bye. So, no tricks then. What shall we do? You want to play basketball? My chicken! She's gone! She's gone!
What? How? When? Who?
Well, she was ill last night. I put her in bed. I read her a story. I kissed her goodnight. And now she's gone.
Oh, Smokey. Maybe it's not so bad. Maybe she's just in the shower. Or gone for a run.
Milly?
Yes?
She's a chicken.
Right. Well, I'm sure she's here somewhere.
Well, I'm not. Someone's taken her, and they've probably eaten her.
I don't think so.
I do.
Why do you think such terrible things?
Well, I found this note.
And what does it say?
It says, I've taken your chicken, and I'll probably eat it.
But who would do that?
I don't know. But next to the note, I found this.
A dog's bone. And this, a dog's biscuit.
And this,
a dog's ketchup. Oh no, you don't think?
I do.
Not.
Yeah. It's a total mystery, isn't it?
Or, maybe it was, Wolfie?
Oh yeah. You've been found guilty of eating Chicken Caesar, an unusual and highly talented young chicken with a promising career in the circus ahead of her. You are, as a punishment, ordered to stay in your kennel for the whole of the summer, and there will be no ball games, no tummy rub, no chocolate biscuits, and a cold bath every week. Oh, drat.
Almost immediately, things began to change in Dragon Valley. Suddenly, bad luck was everywhere. Nobody woke up on time, and when they did, they dropped and broke everything they touched. It rained at every picnic, it was fish every day at school, and everyone missed the bus day after day after day. Smokey and Milly began to feel something terrible had happened. So they decided to ask the wise old lady of the forest for some help.
Come in. Come in. Sorry, hello. Oh, don't get many customers these days. How can I help you? Do you want to go for a ride on a broom? A new range just come in.
Oh, no, thank you.
All right, you want to know why there's suddenly so much bad luck about, I suppose?
Oh, yes.
And you'd like to know what's causing it all?
Oh, yes.
And when you know, you'd like to know how to stop it?
Well, yes.
And how to bring back the good luck?
Yes, that's it.
Me too. Tough one, isn't it?
So you don't know?
No. No idea, sorry.
Oh, no. Is there really nothing you can do?
I can give you a ride on me broom.
No. Is there nothing you can do to help with the bad luck?
Oh, I don't think so. Let me check. Oh, are you going to make a magic brew out of frog's legs and bat wings and lizard eyes? No, no, no. It's all digital these days. I'll just Google it.
Oh,
let me see. Okay, well, I can tell you where the curse comes from, if that helps.
Oh, yes, please.
Well, okay then. It is a poem.
Oh, no.
I hate poems. Some time ago, far out at sea, upon a gentle breeze, a chicken came upon a ship for all on board to see. The bird as golden as the sun brought golden eggs for everyone, and crew and chicken had such fun till Captain Greybeard got his gun. And as he watched his sailors and the chicken joke and cry, he raised and fired his gun two times and then made chicken pie. At once the sea rose up and spat the single question, why? The sea rose up so angry that it broke the boat in two and took away the lives of all the sad and sorry crew. But for Greybeard, it had something worse. His evil act had made a curse. Never die, but sail the seas from then for all eternity, with a crew of demons ship a wreck and the body of a chicken round his neck. So when a wrong is done, Greybeard and his demon ship will come with the baddest luck for everyone until the great wrong is undone. And that's it.
Whoa. Yes.
So, what do you think?
No, I give up. What was all that about?
Well, I think it means that a great wrong has been done in the valley, and we need to make it right.
Oh, yes. I never thought of that.
But how do we know what the great wrong is?
I don't know. I guess we'll have to find it. Shall we start looking in the forest, as usual?
Okay. But can we get the bus this week, Milly?
Sure.
I can give you a lift to the bus stop on my broom.
Okay, let's go.
So the two friends began a frantic search of the forest for the great wrong. They searched high, they searched low, they searched here, they searched there, they searched nowhere, somewhere, and they even searched everywhere. And just when they were about to give up all hope and using their last bus ticket, they found themselves outside the gates of a pretty cottage, looking at a single golden egg.
Ha-ha!
Amelia!
Oh, I can explain.
You can explain that?
Chicken Caesar, what have they done to you?
I'm sorry, I couldn't help myself. I had to have him. I had to.
You stole him. And you let people think it was Wolfie. No, you made them think it was Wolfie. That was a great wrong.
But Milly, it's only Wolfie, and we never liked him anyway.
Wolfie may look different, Amelia. He may be different, but you are a liar, a thief, and a cheat.
And a thief?
Yes, I said that.
And a liar?
Yes.
And a terrorist?
No, she isn't a terrorist.
No?
No, silly.
Oh. But she's not a very nice girl.
No, she isn't.
Milly, I'm sorry.
Amelia, it's too late for that.
No, what are you going to do? Please don't.
Yes.
No.
Yes, come on, Smokey. We're going to tell your mum.
No!
So, little dragon, remember that there are no curses worse than those you make yourself by being bad, cheating, or lying. So even if you have a broken mirror, if you have a good heart, you have nothing to fear. Truly, truly. Now turn off the light and go to sleep, my lucky little dragon.
Yes, Aunt Baba.
Well, I guess there are always exceptions.
Uh-huh.